Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the market commentary from Trading Campus. Now, as we see over here is the daily chart for Nifty. After going through the election outputs on Monday, there was a huge volatility which we have seen. But instead of showing the volatility, what we should understand during the time of downfall, when the markets were opening down on Monday itself, one thing which was very important to know that whether we are getting ourselves correct on the support levels. If you have been following the commentary, one thing was pretty clear as we saw this gap up and bullishness happening after a continuous downfall, and we had basically marked our support levels around these zones, or to be precise, the lower leg of the Moribazu. Okay, when I go ahead and I see during the kind of a fall which we saw over here on that day, it basically touches around this 10,050 or 10,100 mark and it bounces back. So I'm not saying that we should go out and trade at this point. All I'm trying to understand whether my support levels are violated or not, or whatever I have been thought, my thought process is being validated or not, right? So making a profitable trade is not the agenda. The agenda is to understand whether our structures are correct or not, and profit will follow automatically. Now, the most important stuff, as we were trying to discuss prior as well, these were the prior resistance, which is now becoming support for Nifty. That is 10,050 to 10,100 mark. One thing which basically adds more validity to the structure is this kind of volatility. The day of Monday has clearly shown something significant, which information which will help us in our trade setup. Now, what is that? The important point to understand over here, the low which has been made, okay, is basically around these range. So if I just place a small highlighter to understand the importance of this level. So for me now, try to understand if you were stuck over here, how would you get stuck over here if morning it opened gap down? Okay, people would be selling at this point because thinking that now markets are falling and there is a free fall going ahead. The point that you should understand, many people would have been short in 10,200 to 10,050 kind of zone. And then what happens? A complete reversal takes into place. So even if Nifty now comes back to these levels, it cannot go below 10,100 in this expiry for sure. Think about this. If Nifty comes down back in next 3-5 days before the expiry, the guys who were short or stuck at these levels, what will they do? They will buy. So they will provide inherent buying support at these levels of 10,200 to 10,100 zone. So one quick learning that we have got from this volatile scenario, there is a lot of shorts which have been built up around this 10,200 to 10,100 mark, and these shorts which are fixed over here or stuck over here will act as an inherent support, a major inherent support for Nifty, right? So one thing that we have understood, this is a now very important support which will help us as our third leg of bear ratio. Okay, so this is very, very important, 10,100. Now, let's understand what has happened after that. After that, it basically climbs up and it then inches higher to our upper resistance level of 10,400 on that day itself, but closes a little bit shy from 10,400. Following the day, it again opens gap up. The most important point that one should understand, okay, what was the low which is made by this candle? Okay, so the low which has been made, which can be seen on the left hand side, if you see the low, which is 10,406, okay, and the prior resistance was also 10,400. So this basically shows that yes, there is an inherent buying which is taking place above the resistance level. Now these resistance level become a good support level for Nifty. So one thing is, another thing which is clear, the bigger resistance is now taken out, that is 10,400 or 10,370 or 350 to be 380 to be precise. And it is out to become a good resist, good support on the downside of Nifty. So two things are pretty much clear. One is 10,400 becoming a good support. Second, a major support of around 10,200 to 10,100 mark. Okay, but yes, if 10,400 is taken out, there will be a free fall to 10,200 to 10,100. And reason is pretty much clear because of the huge upside which we have seen. Now the fall, a free fall cannot come basically in this expiry. As I said, lot of shorts are stuck over here. Even if Nifty comes back, there will be buying at different levels. Okay, so this is the basic structure that one should understand. Okay, this is more important to understand what volatile scenario has basically pan out for you. So this is pretty much clear that volatile scenario has given me a great input saying that for this expiry, we are sure that it cannot cross 10,100 mark. Now let's go on the upside. What we see today, again today it opens gap up, okay, and it makes a fresh lifetime high. The important point to be understood over here, the upper red Moribazu is there at the higher levels, okay, and today's high was 10,000, almost 10,500, and then a selling is being seen. So gap up bearishness is being seen over here. Obviously the bearishness can continue till 10,430 kind of zone or 10,020 kind of zone, and you can find a reversal. Now our agenda is pretty much clear. There will be a good upside towards 10,600 or 10,700, which can be on the cards. Okay, so we cannot rule out that kind of upside scenario. Now many people are asking, can we buy a put option over here? Okay, the question what you should understand, put option cannot be bought until 10,400 is not taken out. Okay, because till 10,400 is not taken out, it will keep fluttering around this region and your theta impact cost will be huge. So we are not interested in put option. Second, then people ask, can we make bear spread? Now the problem over here is, even if you make bear spreads, the ratios or bear ratios, the cost will be huge. Okay, so we need to wait, and because the downfall cannot come, as I have told you, 10,400 cannot be taken out so easily. Okay, even if it is taken out, there will be inherent buying coming along 10,100 to 10,200 to 250 mark. So ideally the risk rewards are not in my favor by buying put options at these levels. Okay, when it will be more favorable, let us analyze that. If I go out and make a basic indicator, let's say pivot, just to understand how much upside we can find in Nifty, and we have done that prior as well, just to bring everyone on the same page. Just trying to put, let's say, a basic pivot indicator. Now what I see over here on my pivot indicator, the upper resistance level is clearly around the zone of 10,670. Okay, so the resistance level has become the support, which is 10,445. If you see today's low is around that level, right? So what I see over here, almost that resistance is becoming a support. That is good enough, but the point to be understood, there is a bigger upside scenario of 10,668 easily panning out maybe in next couple of days or maybe towards this expiry. Now the question is pretty much clear. If the upper resistance is roughly around this 10,670 zone, I'm not saying let it go there, but at least I want 150 to 200 points upside rally. What happens over here when it goes on the upside rally, I am pretty much sure there will be a quick bounce back on the downward direction from the higher levels. Now from there, I am pretty much clear that yes, at least 300 points fall is expected. And we can cash out that 300 points fall. So my structure remains very, very intact. I would want to basically trade only if there is a quick upside which has happened. And if there is a quick upside in next 3 days, including today, then there will be a quick downside which can happen in 200, 300, 400 points after making a fresh highs around these zones of 10,650 to 10,700 mark. Right, so that one should understand, and it is clearly possible for Nifty to inch higher and then snap back the entire rally of 200, 300 points, coming back and testing at least 10,450, 10,400, but it is pretty much clear 10,400 will not be taken out. right? So that is one of the key inputs now we have on our structure, and 10,400 is acting like a very good support for Nifty. So that is what we are trying to now pan out for going ahead, at least till the expiry. Two things which are very clear: 10,200, 10,100 mark can become a good support line as if and if Nifty starts cracking down. Second support is around this 10,400 mark. And now if it inches higher to 10,600, 650 odd, then we will turn out to be bearish, and we look for our selling pattern, and then we can get into either buying bear spread or bear ratios, right? So that is how you need to structure yourself, rather than buying put options now, because there is much euphoria left on the upside. So we have not yet seen any euphoria yet. Okay, so it has just inched a little higher from the previous high, and it has not yet seen 200, 300 points upside on Nifty, right? So that's Nifty. Let's understand, is banking sector also providing that kind of support to Nifty or not? Now, what I see on the banking side, the same concept is there. Now, bank Nifty normally remains a little more volatile. So if I see over here on the day of the election results, it basically made a quick slip through from 24,800 mark, which was basically a very good resistance level on the downside. But it did went through like a whisker, and then a reversal took place. Now, from day one or from last at least to expiry, for us, the important level is 25,700 mark. Okay, now what we see over here, 25,700 at least. It is trying to budge around that level and trying to push it across 25,700. The important thing one should understand, even after going above this, there is another level of resistance on the higher side, right? So 25,900 again becomes a bigger resistance for Bank Nifty. So one is your 25,700, and then you have your 25,900 kind of zone where again you'll get stuck in Bank Nifty. So there is no huge upside on Bank Nifty as such. All fireworks were basically provided by HDFC Bank. None of the other private banks were supporting Bank Nifty in this up move. Okay, so again, up move can happen if other private banks also starts participating, especially ICICI Bank. But the point is, 25,900 does not seem to be an easy cakewalk for Bank Nifty. The point we need to understand, even if it forms a quick bounce back from these levels and it reaches to 25,900. So the point is, it might take an upside of 300 points, and almost 300 points in Bank Nifty adds 100 points to Nifty. So 100 points to Nifty can bring him up to around this 550 zone. That is purely by banks. But then if IT or pharma or any of the other sectors starts performing, especially ITC or Reliance, then the target of 10,600, 650, 660 cannot be ruled out, right? So bank can provide 100 points to Nifty, and rest 100 points can be brought by other sectors. As we saw yesterday, it was the complete auto day which provided support to Nifty. Okay, so that can be understood, but on the banking side, we are not yet positive. Does not seem to be structure does not seem to be that fitted well as compared to Nifty. Okay, so good upside is not there in Bank Nifty, and it might face resistance on the higher side. Let's take the banks and understand what exactly is happening from the private bank side. All I see over here first is the Yes Bank. As we see Yes Bank, after the fall, it has remained range bound, and the good point of Yes Bank, yesterday, a couple of days back, it basically made a good green buying which took place, and then we see continuous selling coming by. Now, the important point for Yes Bank that we need to understand is around this 307 level, where there was a small gap up and there was a good pull up which has happened during the election day. It did test and again reverse to inch towards 317. Now it is trying to inch lower. So a quick snap recovery can happen in Yes Bank, and it is already a corrected stock. Moment it now crosses 315 or 14, straight away 330 or 323 to 330 kind of zone can be achieved in Yes Bank. Now the important point for Yes Bank is the upper resistance level around these 316. If it crosses, straight away 330 can be on the cards, right? So on the downside, 3067 or something, and if you can find intraday recoveries from these levels, then you can look for 330 on the cards for Yes Bank. So good potential stocks which have corrected enough can basically show a good show, trying to provide support to Bank Nifty. Talking about Kotak Mahindra Bank, which has been amazingly positive stock. Now, if I see over here, it has formed a good bottom, trying to inch higher and then again giving up the gains. For us, again, the important levels for Kotak are around this 1000 and 980 kind of mark, and it can find good reversal from these levels. Right. So even Kotak can provide support, but right now seems to be a little bearish. IndusInd Bank, if I try to see, it has remained range bound. But one important point of IndusInd Bank that you should understand, after the result, it was 1756. It came down, had a quick bounce back around the level of 1700 kind of zone. And again, so it has been punched back and back from these higher levels. The only important stuff which I see on IndusInd Bank, it's basically a triangle formation which is taking place. Okay, so, and it is pretty much clear that this upside of 1700, to be more precise, will be broken. I can tell you with date, it will be roughly around first week of January, or maybe around, not even January, it will be around, first week of January, around 4th or 5th. So 4th or 5th of January, or maybe around 9th of January. So 4th, 5th, 8th and 9th will be the kind of range, first week of January, where it will break 1700 or so, to inch and reach towards 1800. Now the point what we should understand, it is forming a good upside scaling, or I can say higher lows formations are in place. It might come down, might test the gap which we see over here, specifically around the 1600 zone, right? Quick red moribazus have been formed and a quick reversal has been seen around these levels of 1600. So let it correct a bit, let him come down to 1600 odd levels, and you can find a quick reversal from there. And as soon as the first week of January comes, the levels of 1700 can be easily taken out, reaching towards 1750 or so, right? So IndusInd Bank can be an amazing buy, especially with this. Kotak Bank can also be a good buy. So two banks, as I am very bullish upon, can be looked on for Jan month. So that's three good banks. Now let's talk about ICICI Bank, which should provide support to Nifty and Bank Nifty. What is it trying to do? After the election, again, it basically tried to test the lowers levels, which was around this 285 mark. And then you see a quick reversal, which is happening, right? So ICICI is trying to tend or provide some support after the reversals, which are seen from the lower levels, forming a double bottom kind of formation. But the important point one should understand, after the reach has been taken out, 315, again, it has the resistance around these levels of 320 or so. So after going through a quick bull run, I can say from last 2-3 days, then it will get stuck around this 2-320 mark. And at least ICICI is providing some kind of support to Bank Nifty. The important bank which we need to watch is HDFC Bank, which is a good heavyweight with ICICI. Now what I see over here, HDFC has crossed past the important resistance mark of 1875 or so. And after that, we see over here making a good breakout, even today making a fresh high, and then you are finding some selling. But the point is pretty clear, HDFC Bank, even if it comes down to these levels of 1880 or so, there will be a quick reversal around these levels. So as I said, ICICI and HDFC, two banks, can provide good support to Bank Nifty and take it higher at least by 300 points if they reverse. So ICICI is providing good amount of upside. Plus, if HDFC reverses after testing this 1880 mark, you can find a good upside happening in HDFC Bank. So HDFC and ICICI. Now let's take Axis Bank. That's the only bank which is now left. Axis Bank has remained a little range bound. The important point to understand on Axis Bank, The important point is 530, 533, where the prior resistance was there. Continuous supports were formed, and once the good selling took place, it reversed a bit, and on the election day, the same level was tested, right? So 530 was tested again, and you find again Axis Bank is out for an up move towards 560 or so. So Axis Bank is kind of trying to provide support. So that is also good enough. The only point that one should understand on the Axis Bank point of view, it might not go a good upside, might not be there. Now, I'm not yet bullish on Axis Bank because I want to look at stocks which are corrected. So Kotak, IndusInd Bank, Yes Bank are corrected stocks which can give a good recovery going in the month of Jan. Right? So I'm not yet bullish on ICICI, Axis Bank so much compared to those stocks. So that's the banking pack. Let's take some of the sectors which have not performed. So specifically, I'm taking IT. Because there has been a good structures which are forming. So if you see HCL, a good upside was seen in HCL. The breakout kind of scenario happened at 882 and complete selling took place. Now it has come across a good support level of Moribazu, and if it reverses and any reversal pattern which can be seen, straight away 890 can be on the cards, right? 890, and then it can push itself higher towards 910 or so. So that one should keep an eye on. From the IT pack, the stuff which looks weak is Tech Mahindra. Not completely weak, but so Tech Mahindra seems to be very strong, was making fresh 52 week high and stuff. Also, this was the upper resistance of 500. It crossed the upper resistance. Two things which happened over here, which is quite significant. A complete green candle followed by red candle. Number one, number two, and after this 500 mark, it opened gap down. Okay, it opened down, and then it also tested this upper point on the second day, and then again it is trying to inch down. The point for Tech Mahindra can be a little weak below this 500 mark. Reason is pretty much clear. There can be a good downside till 475 or so. So one should understand Tech Mahindra seems to be weak. HCL seems to be strong. Even TCS, I'm not touching Wipro and you can say Infosys because of the buyback stuff, but TCS also has undergone a good amount of fall on the election day. It went down to 2500. A good inch back was taken out. So let's see if TCS can also provide good reversal, but it is in the downward trajectory as of now. It might go and test 2400 or 2435, but those zones will be a good accumulation zone which has happened prior. If you see a good fall which took place and a reversal happened around those zone, and then a complete support is being seen around 2430 or 2375. So also I'm not yet bullish on TCS as much, but the point is if there is a fall in IT pack, I think the first guy to bounce back will be TCS. Right, so we can keep TCS on the cards, then it will be HCL, and then might be Tech Mahindra, Wipro, which are already trading at highs, so there won't be much upside. So from IT pack, it is more important to focus on TCS and HCL. From the pharma pack, we had some stocks with Cipla was gaining very strong even yesterday. Now if I see Cipla on the upside after the huge fall which we have seen, okay, the multiple supports have been taken around this 590 mark, which has now been ruled out. But a better stand to understand is a complete Moribazu has happened over here around this 565 mark. Continuous support has been taken around this 580 zone. And what we see over here after a quick fall and a complete Moribazu fall, what has happened? A quick reversal has taken place. So Cipla is trying to regain the grounds. After the quick falls, which we see a complete reversal is happening after the falls, this basically gives you a signal that yes, Cipla can be one of the counter where a quick reversals can happen. Right now, it has basically moved up enough to face some resistance around the 600 and 620 zone, but the structure seems to be very solid on Cipla. Sun Pharma, also seems to be good enough. If you see, Sun Pharma has remained range bound after the quick fall. So one set of range bound activity happened around this 450 to 500 zone. And what we see after that, this 500 has become a benchmark for Sun Pharma. Okay, so even the election day, if you see, it basically touched 500 or so. I'm not saying it is bullish. It is in the consolidated zone, Sun Pharma. But one thing that we should understand, if we get a downside on Sun Pharma, for not because of the business reason of Sun Pharma, but because of the pharma pack undergoing some stress, these can be the stocks which can be looked upon. Even Lupin seems to now form some kind of support and reversal. When I see over here after the huge fall, and what happens over here, 840 is basically the resistance zone. Then it comes back up. The important point that you will notice over here, and which happens most of the time, 840 was the resistance. Okay, now as I inch higher every day, it crossed 840. Okay, so I'm not saying it just crossed 840, let's go and buy. Something which will help you to understand whether this 840 is a good mark or no. Let's see. The second day also, 840 is the low. Third day also, it is ranging around that. And then it opens slightly in the gap up zone. Okay, then what happens? This is the very good sign of showing that there is an inherent support or buying in Lupin. Now, two things: inherent support and inherent buying. Let us understand. Inherent support means there is a pin bar which comes down almost to 840 and reverses the entire stuff. Okay, whenever you find this kind of pin bar happening during the up move, it will be clear that further up move can be more visible. Okay, so a good test of an up move or a breakout is always a pin bar. Okay, I call this a pin bar. You can also call this as doji, but the point is pin bar because it basically comes down, okay, and reverses all the losses of the day and tries to inch higher, right? So that is one point that you should understand. Also, we are not trying to catch the flying rockets over here. And if you see, there has been a good downside, there is a potential of upside, but I would not go out and buy Lupin at these levels. It is important, let him come down at 840. We have identified this has become an amazing support level for Lupin. Let him come there, let him show us some sign of reversal, and we are out to catch that. Right, so this pin bar kind of trajectory during the up move can always tell you 840 is a very good resistance point. Right, so that one should understand, and it can become a good buying target going ahead around this level of 840. So that's IT and pharma. Majorly, I'm trying to read today because all the auto components have been out and up. So I'm not discussing that. Let's see the gainers and losers for today. Market is still in the red a little bit, but let's see. It's mostly flat. Gainers, what we see over here, Hero Moto is still bouncing up. It was yesterday up by 4%, following up the rally again 2.5%. What we see, Tata Motors is again there. Maruti, as good as the rock solid stock, is bouncing higher. So again, the auto pack is still performing. So Hero Moto, Motors, Tata Motors, Maruti, everyone is there. I'm not looking out to go and buy these stocks right away. But the point is, auto is providing support. Then you have a little bit of Lupin, as we saw, is also providing support. ICICI Bank providing support. The important guy who has come out of lumber is LT. Let's go and see quickly LT. L&T is an amazing stock, which you can basically look for reversal and you can keep looking to buy. The important point one should understand, even after the election falls, the lower low was not made. So now I can basically push my support range around this 1180 mark. Okay, but important to understand over here, the big resistance was this 1200. It inched down, it inched up. Now it is trying to go higher. Now, LT can obviously reach higher levels, but the point is pretty much clear. It won't breach 1240 in a jiffy. It will take its own sweet time to reverse from these levels. But one thing is clear now for LT, I will always look out for 1210, 1200 levels, which are very important for me if I am interested to buy LT. It's one of the promising stock which will perform very good in January month. 1280 on the cards of LT is clearly possible. A fresh 52-week high, lifetime high, everything can happen in LT. But the only point that you should understand is to buy at a good lower level when you get reversals and enter into that stock, trying to target for 1280 in the month of Jan. Okay. So those are pretty much the gainers list. Even one guy is there called as ONGC, which basically shows oil is inching higher. As I am telling you, oil, if it starts bringing up on the upper side and Nifty also goes up, the last week of correction will come from oil, right? So that was our December outlook, which we had made a month back now. It can pan out. So whenever I see ONGC in the gainer side, I always have a feeling that oil is inching high, right? So that should be there on the back of your mind. If ONGC is on the gainer side, losers, let us see. There has to be BPCL, IOC, HPCL, and here they are. HPCL is there, BPCL is there. So Gale on ONGC on the gaining side and HPIOC on the losing side. The important point to be understood over here, the commodity pack is seeing a little bit of uptick today because it has been going up quite for some time. The important point is to understand Hindustan Unilever seems to be weak. Okay, so one of the stock FMCG which seems to be a little weak, rest we have almost covered. Kotak we seem to be was weak, SBI is fine, Axis Bank is fine. So HUL, which was a performing star, suddenly seems to be weak. Let's understand. What is happening in HUL? So FMCG front seems to be strong enough, but if you see over here, it is in the complete up zone territory, uncharted, and trying to make highest highs around these levels. So even the lower level, which I see, is 1300 for HUL, and the other support can be around this level of 1290 or so, where the gap up happened. So the important point to be understood over here, HUL is inching high. It's only today that it is trying to give away some of the gains. Important point is FMCG is trying, or HUL is trying to make the upward march. It can come down. 1300 can become a very good support for HUL. Now, apart from HUL, let us see and not forget ITC. ITC can be a big mover on the index. And if I see ITC, one thing which is very, very clear, from the lows of 250, it just took 2 days and 3 days is inched back to 266. Okay, so the major uptick rally which happened in ITC also provided support to Nifty. Now, what I see over here during the time of election, the volatile time also, 257 was a very good support on ITC. So let him come down around this 257 support. If Nifty has to go high, it can be the last guy who will be pushing Nifty higher. It will be ITC. And as we see the double bottom formation over here, second selling has been taken up. And I think there will be a quick upside in ITC, which is possible going towards January. But the point one should understand, if Nifty starts going up because of HUL, ITC, one or two stocks, or maybe Reliance, then there is a point of selling which can come anytime, right? So let's keep a watch on ITC as well. So that's it for today. More or less, the aviation stocks, as the oils are going up, paint and Asian Paint, Pidilite, they can also be under some stress. So that also needs to be taken care of. Let's connect again tomorrow. More or less, from Nifty side, we are pretty much clear. We are bullish on Nifty. Our target is 10,600 to 10,650 kind of zone. And we will look for bearish around those levels to make our structure place our bear ratio. Right. So till now, we don't do anything. We look for our structural setup in individual stocks and reversals if you want to trade. But making a bear ratio on Nifty will only pan out if Nifty inches higher towards this level. Otherwise, we do not do anything for this expiry. Fine. Thank you very much for joining in, and we'll rejoin tomorrow.